Welcome back, friends. In this session, we will learn about one more immunological technique, which is known as Coombs test. So before discussing the actual Coombs test, first we will discuss why this Coombs test was developed. So whenever we have to detect the presence of particular antibodies in serum sample, in that case, first we take out the serum sample from the affected person, and then we mix the serum sample with the respective antigen in appropriate concentration. So what happens if that particular sample contains antibodies? They will bind to the antigen in a specific manner, like this. So in this pattern, one antibody, it is binding to two different antigens, and two antigens, they are binding to the single antibody. So in other way, we can say that two antibodies, they are competing to bind a single antigen, and these two antigens, they are also competing to bind a single antibody. So under these conditions, what happens after binding of antigen and antibody and after development of this particular pattern, which is also called as lattice? So this pattern of antigen antibody binding is known as lattice. So if they bind in this particular manner, the reaction becomes visible. So it can be easily detected by naked eyes. So this reaction is either called as agglutination if the size of antigen is much larger, and precipitation if the size of antigen is very small, if the antigen is soluble. So in this case, the reaction will become visible. But remember one thing, this pattern is very important. Without this pattern, antibodies cannot be detected. In 1935, two scientists, Hedel Berger and Kendall, they discovered a different kind of antibody, which they called as low-grade antibody. These antibodies are able to bind their target antigen, but they are not able to either agglutinate or precipitate it, and that's why they called it as low-grade antibody. So what will happen if a person's blood or serum contains such kind of low-grade antibodies? If we try to detect them with the help of agglutination or precipitation reaction, that is by simply addition of antigen which are specific to that antibody molecule, this antibody will bind to them, but reaction will not become visible in the form of agglutination or precipitation. So that's why it will be very difficult to detect such kind of antibody molecules. In 1945, again another scientist, Robin Coombs, studied low-grade antibodies formed in a condition known as hemolytic disease of newborn. And these low-grade antibodies are formed against the Rh antigen, which are present on the surface of RBCs. He called these anti-Rh antibodies as incomplete antibodies because they can bind to the surface of RBCs, but they cannot agglutinate them. And that's why Coombs modified the existing test for detection of antibodies, which is popularly known as Coombs test. He also gave the possible reason that why these incomplete antibodies or the low-grade antibodies are not able to agglutinate the target antigen, or in this case the RBCs. The first possible reason is that these incomplete or low-grade antibodies are monovalent. Monovalent antibodies means the antibody molecule having only one antigen binding site. And the second possible reason is that these antibody molecules may be very small. So what will happen if the antibody molecule is monovalent and if the size of antibody molecule is very small? In both the cases, lattice will not form. So what is lattice? As we have discussed earlier, in lattice, one antibody molecule, it binds to two different antigen at the same time. So such antibody molecule is called as bivalent antibody. So if the antibody molecule is monovalent, it cannot cross-link two antigen at the same time. And if the size of antibody molecule is very small, if it is too short, in that case also it will be difficult to cross-link two antigen at the same time. So because of these two reasons, these antibody molecule may not agglutinate the RBCs or any antigen. So for detection of such kind of antibody molecules, Coombs developed a reagent which he called as anti-human globulin. Now it is also called as Coombs reagent. Now what is this anti-human globulin? So anti-human globulin is nothing but antibody molecule which can bind to that anti-Rh antibody, that is the incomplete antibody molecule. So it is nothing but antibody which can bind to that anti-Rh antibody which actually binds to the RBC. So such anti-antibody molecule is called as Coombs reagent. Now let us see the actual Coombs test now. And for that we will consider one example. Suppose one woman is suspected to have produced anti-Rh antibodies, that is anti-RBC antibodies. So if that woman has produced such kind of antibodies, these antibodies will exist in two forms. Which are those forms? First is called as bound antibodies. So what are bound antibodies? Bound antibodies means these antibodies have coated to the surface of RBC. They have bound to the surface of RBC. And the second form is the free antibodies. That is the antibodies which are not bound to the surface of RBCs. So these antibodies will exist in these two forms, the bound antibodies and the free antibodies. There are two types of Coombs test. One is called as direct Coombs test and second, the other is called as indirect Coombs test. In direct Coombs test, the bound antibodies are detected, while in indirect Coombs test, the free antibodies are detected. In direct Coombs test, first blood from the affected woman is centrifuged. And this bottom part which contains RBCs is taken for analysis. If that woman has produced anti-Rh antibodies, so in this particular part, we can find the bound antibodies because all the RBCs can be settled down by centrifugation. And if RBCs are settled down, along with them, the bound antibodies can be settled down. So this part will contain bound antibodies like this. And then RBCs means that particular part is then mixed with anti-human globulin, that is the antibodies against the incomplete antibodies, anti-Rh antibodies. So what will happen if we mix these two contents? This anti-human globulin molecule, they will bind to the antibodies which are bound to the RBCs. But in this case, the binding will be like this, which will lead to the formation of lattice. And if lattice is formed, it will result in the visible agglutination. Okay, so if agglutination is seen, this means that RBC molecule, they are coated with incomplete antibody molecules. So positive test is agglutination, visible agglutination. In case of indirect Coombs test, serum sample is used instead of RBCs. First, the serum sample which may contain the incomplete anti-Rh antibody molecules, it is mixed with RBC. So these RBCs, they are not from the patient, they are added externally from the kit. So in the first step, the sample, that is serum, that is which contains the incomplete antibody molecule, they are mixed with RBCs. So what will happen? This antibody molecule present in serum, they will bind to the RBC which are externally added, and antigen antibody complex will form. And after that, anti-human globulin, that is Coombs reagent, is added. So what will happen? In this case also, the Coombs reagent, that is anti-human globulin, they will cross-link the antibody molecule, the incomplete antibody molecule, leading to the formation of lattice like this. And in this case also, the visible agglutination can be seen. So in this case also, visible agglutination is the positive test. So in this way, Coombs developed a technique in which incomplete antibodies can be detected. There are many conditions in which our body can produce such incomplete antibodies against RBCs. These conditions are autoimmune hemolytic anemia, drug-induced hemolytic anemia, and erythroblastosis fetalis, that is hemolytic disease of newborn. In all these conditions, our body can produce antibodies against incomplete antibodies against RBC, and if they bind to our RBC, they can even destroy it and can develop a condition known as anemia, that is reduction in the number of RBCs.